The ground beneath our feet is alive with many different types of organisms. Aside from the worms and other large or macro critters that all of us can see, there are many different tiny microscopic organisms which play a crucial role in all of our lives. These microscopic organisms, simply called microorganisms or microbes, help to deposit key nutrients into the soil, which are required for plants to grow. The major nutrient that these microbes put into the soil is nitrogen. Plants are unable to receive nitrogen from the air. So, how do microbes deliver this key nutrient to plants? The main two types of microbes in the soil are bacteria and fungi, as concluded by M. Hayatsu. Both of these organisms play a key role in the nitrogen cycle. This cycle takes nitrogen from one source, such as the air all around us, and alters the form of that nitrogen with the help of the microbes, so that it can be used by a completely different source, such as plants. This process of taking nitrogen out of the air and putting it into the soil for plants to use is called nitrification. The bacteria and fungi that perform nitrification are called nitrifying microbes. There are also microbes that do the opposite, so they take nitrogen out of the soil and put it back into the air. These are called denitrifying microbes. There is one other key pathway that nitrogen takes. Since nitrogen is part of all living organisms, when some creature dies, there are decomposing microbes that turn the previously living creature's nitrogen into nitrogen that can be used by other currently living organisms, such as plants. These three processes make up the main points of the nitrogen cycle. Some of these microbes are attached to the root systems of plants. This is a key symbiotic relationship, meaning the working together of two or more species for a common goal, such as the relationship between fungi and the plants with a great need for nitrogen. Bacteria also perform symbiotic relationships with plants. Microbes play a role in 80 to 90% of all the processes that occur in soil that make nutrients available for other, more complex forms of life, such as plants and animals, who need these nutrients, but who can't get them directly from their natural state. There are many microorganisms with similar function, including the multiple types of bacteria and fungi that all take part in the nitrogen cycle. There are microbes that freely move about in the soil, and there are those microbes that are attached to the roots. These similarities in function of microbes are crucial, because it will ensure that there are always nutrients available. Without a vast array of different organisms, all of one type of nitrifying fungi may die after a cold summer's evening. If this were to be the only type of nitrifying microbe in your soil, then all of the plant life in the area would quickly die. This diversity among many types of soil microbes allows for interactions of new symbiotic relationships to form. It is believed that there is some minimum level of species diversity necessary for proper function of the soil and for maintaining stability in nutrient production. A great example of this is shown in the study done by B.S. Griffith and others. This study showed that when some soil bacteria were killed with fumigation, or gases being pumped into the soil, that there was a statistically significant decrease in soil function. Without this stable source of nutrients, many of the plants that we depend on today may not be able to produce as much food or other beneficial products for other animals, such as humans.